The Pentagon has named a new commission that has 90 days to recommend solutions to the longstanding and widespread issue of sexual assault in the military. Nick Schifrin speaks to advocates for survivors about some proposed changes.
When service members report a sexual assault, by law, they're assigned a victim advocate. And as you'll hear from four victim advocates, the new commission must tackle fundamental problems.
Over the past decade, the number of reported sexual assaults has doubled from 3,327 in 2010 to 7,825 in 2019. But the actual number of sexual assaults, including those not reported, is estimated to be 20,000. In a briefing last month obtained by PBS NewsHour, the Army admitted soldiers are more likely to get raped by someone in the same uniform as you than you are to be shot by the enemy. And if you commit sexual assault within the Army, you're more likely than not able to get away with your crime.
The military is built on trust. If we're at home and I can't trust you to take care of me then, how can I trust you to take care of me on the battlefield?
Retired Sergeant First Class Quentin McNair had a 24-year Army career as a drill sergeant, helicopter crew chief, and sexual assault response coordinator and victim advocate. He calls the commission announcement a little progress.
It's a good sign that we're continuing to take measures that emphasize the importance of trying to resolve this issue. It's a bad sign that we have to take those measures.
If you had to grade how the military has done stamping out sexual assault, what grade would it be?
It would be an absolute F.
Marianne Buston had a 24-year Navy career. She was a sexual assault and response coordinator in uniform and after retirement as a contractor. She says commanders often care more about their careers than victims.
If I say, okay, we've had 3 sexual assaults, 5 sexual assaults, instead of saying, oh my gosh, you know, let's take care of these victims, what do we need to do? They start looking at it like, oh, is this going to look poorly on me? They just don't want to do what needs to be done.
Let's say the commander just didn't believe it was sexual assault. They were like, nope, it was consensual. That was consensual sex. That report can stop at its tracks right there.
Lindsay Knapp was a soldier in the 2000s, then became a victim advocate in 2014. She's now the executive director of the organization Combat Sexual Assault. She says commanders who are colonels, one step below brigadier general, are especially prone to cover-ups.
Those commanders are more apt to not act in the best interest of their service members. And so that's really... that level of command is where my problem lies. When that victim reports, the commander will just say, oh, you know what, that was consensual. Because they don't want to have to deal with the fact that somebody who had power and authority over this victim was a rapist.
The chain of command made their own determination. They don't get to do that. An allegation, regardless of how valid you think it is, has to be by law forwarded to law enforcement. They are mandated reporters.
Amy Frank has been a civilian Army victim advocate and program manager since 2013 and founded Never Alone Advocacy. She says the solutions begin with taking away the power that military commanders currently hold over victims' advocates and whether to prosecute or punish alleged perpetrators.
The sexual assault advocacy program has to be moved away from the chain of command immediately. The special victims councils and the special sexual assault response coordinators and all of the advocates need to be moved in their own command away from the chain of command so we can actually have some teeth to hold people accountable so that when people don't do the right thing, that we have our own separate entity to deal with them.
Love, right?
The changes must begin at the beginning, at boot camp, with better training and a discussion about culture, says McNair.
You have to make the water so toxic for sharks to swim that they can't attack people. Instead of just saying, hey, this is the definition of sexual assault. This is how many days you have to report sexual assault. Let's pair that information with an actual real discussion, you know, that is generated to attack and to change the culture.
Advocates say that culture change must include respecting victims and their advocates. The recent Army briefing concluded 66% of victims report retaliation or ostracism, most often from their chain of command. In 2019, Amy Frank was suspended after saying her commanders were mishandling sexual assault cases. Last year, the Air Force National Guard fired Marianne Buston. She's currently fighting to get her job back.
My command brought me up on false allegations, wrongfully terminated me. I brought up sexual harassment at the unit, and they just didn't want to hear about it.
And Lindsay Knapp says she was fired last year after questioning whether her commander was creating barriers to report sexual assault.
If it was working, retaliation would be plummeting. But that is not what we are seeing. So what we're seeing is a failure in military leadership. Because when folks like me report that our service members are being retaliated against for reporting, they fire us. And then what then? That sends a clear message to the unit. Do not report your sexual assault because we are coming for you.
It's not working. If it was working, we wouldn't be having this conversation. You know, if it was working, I wouldn't have young soldiers be having violent sexual assaults with their bones broken and people saying that that was consensual sex.
The most pressing task facing this commission is accountability for those who have committed sexual assault.
On Friday, the Pentagon introduced Lynn Rosenthal as the new commission's head. She's a former Obama administration White House advisor on violence against women.
For many, their dreams were shattered by the trauma of sexual violence and sometimes retaliation for coming forward. This must end.
McNair says after the abuse he's experienced and witnessed in victims, he doesn't want his daughter to follow in his footsteps.
My daughter is the age now where I joined the military. I've seen the ugliest part of the military, and that's not something I would want to expose my child to.
It's a generations-old problem that now extends across generations. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Nick Schifrin.